For us Earthlings, there are few things as constant as the sun. But the sun is actually spinning, and weirdly, the layer of gas at its surface spins slower than the gas beneath it. We've known this for a while, like almost 30 years, but scientists have never had a great explanation for it. But now, a team of astronomers thinks they have finally cracked the case. They think that outside layer could be moving more leisurely because the sun is just so dang bright. The light acts as a brake. This all started back in the 1980s when scientists were studying the sun with something called helioseismology. It's kind of like how seismologists monitor the waves moving through the Earth to learn more about earthquakes. With helioseismology, physicists can use vibrations to understand what's going on in the sun. Using these techniques, they could see that the sun's equator rotates faster than the poles, something that astronomers had known for centuries. They also saw that the solar surface rotates slower than the gas underneath it. But here's the thing. Helioseismology is really only good at giving astronomers a really big picture, what's happening in chunks of the sun like 3,000 kilometers across or deep. And the sun's surface is constantly moving and changing for loads of different reasons. So scientists knew about the different layer, different speed mystery, but didn't have a way to explain it. Now, 3 decades later, astronomers have a new tool, NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory satellite. This satellite lets them watch how the gases at the very edge of the sun's surface move with resolution of 10 kilometers. Using 3.5 years of data, the team tracked changes in the sun's outer layer. And in a paper published in Physical Review Letters, they show that most of the slowdown happens in just the outer 70 kilometers of the solar surface, not the entire thing. This very outer edge is where light escapes into space, and the researchers realized that sunlight itself might be what's slowing down the sun's spin. That's because photons of light have momentum, which they take from whatever's emitting the light. And if whatever's emitting the light is moving sideways, like the sun's surface does, light steals some of that sideways momentum too. Each photon steals an unimaginably small amount of momentum, but the sun is really bright, and it's given off a lot of photons over its lifetime. Researchers did the math and found that sunlight slowly siphoning off momentum can just about completely explain the difference in speeds between the sun's layers. They still aren't positive that this is the major cause of the slowdown, but it seems pretty likely. And do not worry, the sun is not going to stop spinning anytime soon, they checked, and a total slowdown would take far longer than the 5 billion years our stellar neighbor has left. Next, let's talk about NWA. No, not the hip-hop NWA, not the airline, that doesn't exist anymore, the rock version, NWA 7635. NWA stands here for Northwest Africa, because that's where the rock was found, but it's no ordinary rock, it's from Mars. And a group of scientists think this meteorite could be proof that at least one Martian volcano has been continuously spewing magma for more than 2 billion years. That is unheard of on the Earth's surface. Here we have plate tectonics shifting everything around, so volcanoes would really never last for more than a few million years. NWA 7635 is one of about 100 Mars rocks scientists have found on Earth, expelled from the Martian surface by things crashing into it. On their way here, those rocks get exposed to high-energy cosmic rays that change some of their atoms into weird isotopes or elements that weren't originally there. And the longer they're floating out in space, the more weird atoms are in the rocks. So based on what they're made of, and how long they were in space, scientists can tell roughly when they got kicked off Mars. NWA 7635 is really similar to 10 other volcanic rocks called shergatites, which are Martian meteorites made up of certain elements and minerals. This specific group of shergatites got launched into space about 1 million years ago and formed about 300 to 600 million years ago. But when the researchers actually checked NWA 7635's age, they found that it's not a few hundred million years old, it's nearly 2.5 billion years old. Because these rocks are all made of the same stuff, that means that there must have been a volcano or volcanic system making new rocks in the same spot for more than 2 billion years. In other words, it was erupting for over 40% of Mars's history. And that is a persistent volcano. Planetary scientists have argued for years about whether Mars has or ever had plate tectonics, and they'll probably keep arguing. But NWA 7635 shows that even if the surface did shift around, it probably never worked much like Earth, where the planet is significantly rearranged every couple hundred million years. And it just goes to show that we don't always need to jet all the way over to the red planet to learn about its history. The rocks just
come to us.
Though we should totally go to the rocks as soon as possible. This episode of SciShow is brought to you by The Great Courses Plus, where you can get unlimited access to over 7,000 different video lectures taught by award-winning professors from the Ivy League and other top schools around the world about anything that interests you. Science, literature, even the history of astronomy, like this course from Dr. Bradley E. Schaefer called The Remarkable Science of Ancient Astronomy. Right now, The Great Courses Plus is offering SciShow viewers a free one-month trial. Go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/scishowspace to have access to the 7,000 video lecture library, or click on the link in the description below. If you've been waiting for the next thing in space fashion, get ready, because Boeing is about to blow your mind. Meet Boeing Blue. Boeing's